Biden will sign the $1.25 trillion infrastructure bill later this morning. So what's the impact for the economy and for the markets? For more on this, let's bring in Congressman Josh Gottheimer of New Jersey. He's the co-chair of the Bipartisan Problem Solvers Caucus. And Josh, thank you for being here. This is a bill that passed with bipartisan support. And just every state, I think basically every district, is going to have some money headed its way to try and fix infrastructure. What does it mean, and how soon will we see this money?
Becky, thanks for having me. It's good to see you. As you know, we've been working on this for a long time, Democrats and Republicans, to get this over the finish line. So it's a huge win for the country, for Democrats, Republicans, and as you pointed out, for every state. You're talking about roads, bridges, rail, transit, broadband, water infrastructure. Here in Jersey, we're going to get the Gateway Tunnel. That's the train tunnel between New York and New Jersey that's over 100 years old, the current tunnel, and literally crumbling. We're going to get that replaced with the new Gateway Tunnel. So on every front, this is going to be key to not just fixing a crumbling infrastructure that is not competitive now, but allow us to actually do what we need to do and create 2 million jobs a year for the next decade.
Josh, already talk has turned to what comes next with the second bill, the Build Back Better. This is the one where there's not Democratic consensus, and this is one that you've kind of been holding out on. I know that you've said that you will vote for this if the CBO score comes back and shows that it's paid for. What are you anticipating with that number, and what happens if it's not paid for?
So what we've asked for, a group of us, is just to make sure we see, get more data from the Congressional Budget Office on the revenue side and obviously on the investment side. We expect to get that data this week and for it to match up with what we received from the Treasury Department and the White House, and then we'll be able to move forward. You know, Becky, for Northern New Jersey, the Build Back Better reconciliation bill is critical. Obviously, and one of the things that you and I have talked about a lot is reinstating SALT, the state and local tax deduction, to get tax cuts for people here in Northern New Jersey. That'll do that in this piece of legislation. It also includes critical investments in things like childcare and universal pre-K and helping us fight climate change. So lots of good things for Northern New Jersey. We've just wanted and been working on it for months with our colleagues in the Senate to get it more targeted and focused, and obviously good for Jersey. That's what I'm focused on. And we wanted the time to make sure we looked at it and analyzed the legislation, and we've been doing that over the last week and feel very good about where it's at. We're just waiting on some more of that data, and then we can move forward.
Senator Joe Manchin, also a Democrat, has said that he thinks they're playing with numbers here, that because the length of the programs has been shortened, that's how you get to those numbers. If the CBO score comes back and says that this is too expensive and SALT is part of what pushes that over the line, what will you do? What's more important to you, SALT and getting this or getting any deal done?
Well, I've always said no salt, no dice, and that's how I feel about it. The SALT is actually paid for in the way it's structured, so that's not a concern. Listen, I think part of why we've asked for more data from the CBO is to look at this and analyze it and make sure that, as Joe Manchin said, that we analyze it properly. And I think that's the responsibility of any legislator, to take the time to look, go through every single page and make sure you understand what's in it. And that's what we've been doing. And again, I think this is a great bill in terms of reinstating SALT and cutting taxes and making life more affordable to childcare, to pre-K. You know, there's so much in here that's good. Just like, Becky, the infrastructure bill, which the president will sign today, which, you know, it took a long time to get Democrats and Republicans together and get all the Democrats to agree. But we got there, and now we've got to actually get to work and get these resources out and start helping our communities.
There were six progressives who voted no on that deal, and there's been a lot written and a lot kind of speculated about the problems in the party right now, just the big divides that are there.
And as a reminder, that the squad members might have voted against it, but you know, we got help from problem solver Republicans who came along and you know, did the right thing. You know, we all helped write the bill going back to April when we started talking about this piece of legislation. Democrats and Republicans in the House and the Senate did this the way legislation should happen, right? Working together. That's how we came up with the resources for the roads and the bridges and the rails and the airports and ports. And that, I think, really will help in the end by doing it that way. And listen, you know, obviously there were some disagreements in the Democratic Party, but the bottom line is we got it across the finish line.
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.